वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू माय क्लास। लॉग नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, ट्रायंगुलर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशंस, पॉइजन प्रोसेस एंड एम्पिरिकल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशंस टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी। दिस इज बेस्ड अंडर मॉडल नंबर 2, स्टैटिस्टिकल मॉडल्स इन सिमुलेशन। सो लॉग इज सेम एज लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल, फॉर लॉग 5 मीन्स 1/5, दिस अ बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट। एंड ट्रायंगुलर, वी हैव अ 3 वेरिएबल्स फॉर ट्रायंगुलर, यू कैन कंसिडर एनी इट एज एबीसी, एक्स वाई जेड, एनीथिंग। And poison process. In this poison process, we have two things. This is actually a countably infinite or uncountably infinite. And we have a terms of process during the time interval 0, t. And we have two statements. One is stationary increments and another one is independent increments. And empirical distributions. So this is a new concept and we'll see one by one. So log normal distribution, a random variable x has a log normal distribution if its PDF has a form for if the condition satisfied x greater than 0, like 0 means 1, 2, 3, etc. So f of x is equal to 1 divided by root 2 pi sigma x and exponential of log x minus mu the whole square divided by 2 sigma square. So here sigma is nothing but a standard deviation and it's exponential 1. And mu is a service time, and so this is how if x greater than 0 is satisfied, then we can go for the formula this one. Otherwise, we can go for 0. There is a mean and variance over here. So mean e of x is equal to e power mu plus sigma square by 2, and variance v of x is equal to e power 2 mu plus sigma square by 2 into e power sigma square minus 1. So this is the mean and variance for the log normal distribution. So as I already said that example, for this we can say, for example, log 10 is 1/10. So based on this formula, we can go for it. And now triangular distribution. So triangular distribution having a 3 variables over here as a, b, c, and x is a random variable, and it is having a triangular distribution. F of x is equal to if for example a to b is a condition, a less than or equal to x less than or equal to b, so 2 into x minus a by b minus a and c minus a, and b is the common variable over here, and so that mode occurs at x equal to b, because b is a common one for both the conditions. So b less than x less than or equal to c, so 2 into c minus x divided by c minus b into c minus a. So they have given a mode which occurs at the random variable x equal to b, so that a less than equal to b less than or equal to c. So we can take mean a plus b plus c divided by 3. Why? Because by 3 variables we have, so that they have taken these 3 variables. And mode equal to b equal to 3 e of x minus a plus c. So this is the mode. Why? Because b is the common one. So they have taken mode occurs at a random variable. Now we are going to see the poison process. N of t is a counting function that represents the number of events occurred during the time interval 0, t. And we have a counting process which arrivals occur one at a time. One is a stationary increments and another one is a independent increments. So stationary increments, it is a dependent one, and independent increments is an independent one. And during non-overlapping only, the number of intervals will occur. And then both similarities, we can say stationary increments and independent increments having a completely random arrivals are completely random here. So in stationary increments, number of arrivals in t comma t plus s depends only on s, not on starting point t. So because there is a condition which is t greater than or equal to 0, so arrivals are completely random. And here in independent increments, during non-overlapping time, these number of arrivals are independent. So future arrivals occurs completely random. So poison process is nothing but it's a countably infinite or uncountably infinite during the time interval 0, t. And we have two increments, one is stationary increments and another one is a independent increments. So both the same, what we can see in this two similarities, we can see completely random arrivals are completely random. The only thing is in stationary it is a dependent one, and independent it's a independent one. Now we'll see the poison process. So we have two properties in this, random splitting and pooled process. So in random splitting, we have a low priority and high priority. So each arrival is marked any one of the priorities depend upon the conditional strategies, and we have a lambda, that is an arrival rate. So each job arrives at a shop in accordance with the Poisson process having rate lambda. And for example, high priority with probability 1 by 3 and low priority with probability 2 by 3. So type 1 event can correspond to high priority and type 2 event could correspond to low priority. So we have 2-1, N1 of T and N2 of T. These are the variables which follow the Poisson process with rates lambda by 3 and 2 lambda by 3 respectively. So they are taking 1 by 3 is for high priority and 2 by 3 is for low priority. And then pooled is nothing but a combined process. So a Poisson arrival stream with lambda 1 is equal to 10. Here what they are coming to say is combined is nothing but a pooled with a Poisson arrival stream. So for example, arrival rate is one arrival rate is 10 per hour and another arrival rate is 17 arrival per hour. You can combine both the two things, 17 and 10. So 10 and 17, if you sum up, they will get a 27. Okay, so this is the combined process which is explained in this properties. So normally we have two properties, one is random splitting and another one is pooled process. Simply we can summarize, this one is random splitting. We have high priority, that is 1 by 3, and low priority 2 by 3. So pooled process, we are going to combine the two arrival rates, for example lambda 100, lambda 2 200. So sum up, totally we'll get a 300. Now a non-stationary Poisson process is characterized by lambda t, the arrival rate at time t. So this is useful for situations in which the arrival rate varies during the period of interest, including meal time of, for example, real time example we can see is meal time for restaurants and phone calls during the business hours and orders for pizza delivery around 6 p.m. So this is how the examples for Poisson process. And empirical distribution. So a distribution whose parameters are the observed values in the sample of data. So this may be used when it is impossible or unnecessary to establish a random variable in any particular parametric distribution. So empirical is nothing but the parameters in this, we can take it as observed values. And there is an advantage, there is no any assumptions beyond the observed values in the sample. And disadvantages is the entire range of possible values it won't might cover. For example, 5 to 10. So it won't cover from 5 to 10. It will take only the rare values. So an example they have given, the customers arrives in group from 1 to 8 persons. Observation of lost 300 groups has been reported. And we have a summary of those groups as into that. Thank you.